हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ पीयूष कुमार वर्मा एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट कन्वेंशन ऑन बायोलॉजिकल डाइवर्सिटी विच इज़ अ लीगली बाइंडिंग ट्रीटी एंड विच केम एज एन आउटकम ऑफ अर्थ समिट हेल्ड इन रियो डी जिनेरो ऑन 5 June 1992 एंड इंटर इन टू फोर्स ऑन 29 December 1993 एंड कॉमनली नोन एज बायोडाइवर्सिटी कन्वेंशन। फ्रेंड्स, सो मैं आप लोगों को रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि जो अगर आपको यूनाइटेड नेशन कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन एनवायरनमेंट एंड डेवलपमेंट की अगर बात करें तो अगर आपको ये अर्थ समिट को देखना है तो आप मेरे प्रीवियस वीडियो पे जाके देख सकते हैं। मैंने उसके लिए प्रॉपर एक वीडियो बनाया है और ये इसी का यानी कि अर्थ समिट का ही आउटकम था कि कन्वेंशन ऑन बायोलॉजिकल डाइवर्सिटी एग्जिस्टेंस में आई और ये 29 दिसंबर 1993 को इट एंटर्ड इंटू फोर्स। And now we shall talk about objectives. So what are the objectives? Its objective are conservation of biological diversity or biodiversity, sustainable use of its components, and fair and equitable sharing of benefits arising from genetic resources. The idea is to develop national strategies for the conservation and sustainable use of biological diversity. The convention affirms the following: first, intrinsic value of biodiversity; second, biodiversity conservation as common concern of humankind; third, sovereign rights of states over their biological resources; fourth, responsibility of states to conserve and sustainably use their biodiversity; and fifth, precautionary approach towards biodiversity conservation; and sixth, vital role of local communities and women. So, need for provisions of new and additional financial resources and access to technologies for developing countries to address biodiversity loss. So friends, next we are going to talk about members and signatories to CBD. Friends, अभी के लिए अगर देखा जाए तो वर्तमान में 196 parties and signatories जो हैं उनकी संख्या 168 है और भारत को भी इसमें इंक्लूड कर ले तो US जो है इसको साइन तो किया है लेकिन इसको अभी तक रेटिफाइड नहीं किया है। और जो मेन कंसर्न USA के थे वो ये थे सीबीटी प्रोविजंस को लेके, और उसने सबसे बड़ी बात जो थी कि सीबीटी के अकॉर्डिंग जो है सीबीटी ने डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज़ को जो है टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रांसफ़र करने के लिए बाइंड किया था जो भी डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज़ थी, तो इससे यूएसए सहमत नहीं था। यूएसए थिंक्स दैट इट कुड थ्रीटन यूएस इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी इंटरेस्ट। सो फर्दर देयर इज अनदर रीजन दैट द ऑब्लिगेशन for financial and aid under the CBD are vague. So strangely, other developed countries have not shared these concerns, but especially USA has done so. Anyway, now we shall talk about administration. So the governing body of CBD is the Conference of Parties, consisting all governments and regional economic integration organization that have ratified the treaty. So far 12 meeting of COP have taken place. So the last meeting was held in October 2014 in Pyeongchang, South Korea. And friends, this point is most important. India ne Hyderabad mein yani COP 11 ka jo hai COP 11 ki hosting ki thi, to ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट हो जाता है क्वेश्चन के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से। अगर बात करें तो सीबीटी का सेक्रेटेरिएट वो मॉन्ट्रियल में है यानी कनाडा, और ये जो है कहीं ना कहीं यूनाइटेड नेशंस एनवायरनमेंट प्रोग्राम के अंतर्गत ऑपरेट करता है। सो देयर इज अ सब्सिडियरी बॉडी फॉर साइंटिफिक टेक्निकल एंड टेक्नोलॉजिकल एडवाइस दैट इज द SBSTTA विच हैज़ एक्सपर्ट्स फ्रॉम मेम्बर्स government competent in relevant field. It plays a key role in making recommendation to the conference of parties on scientific and technical issues. So ab hum baat karenge ki what are the importance of CBD. So CBD is a landmark in international law on environment because for the first time it recognized that conservation of biological diversity is a common concern of humankind and it is an integral part of the development process. So it covers all ecosystem, species and genetic resources. It links traditional conservation efforts to the economic goal of using biological resources sustainably. It sets principles for the fair and equitable sharing of benefits arising from the use of genetic resources, notably those designed for commercial use. It also covers the rapidly expanding field of biotechnology, addressing technology development and transfer, benefit sharing, and biosafety. Since the convention is legally binding, countries that join it are obliged to implement its provision. So, friends, this is a very noting point. When is the summit, and this is a current affair also, when is the summit on biodiversity about to be held for this year 2020? So, answer is, the summit on biodiversity will be convened by the President of General Assembly at United Nations headquarters in New York on the first and second day of general debate of Assembly on 22nd and 23rd September 2020. The meeting takes place on the margins of the opening of 75th session of UN General Assembly. Heads of states and government are expected to be in attendance. Now we shall talk about protocols to CBD. So, यहाँ पर दो protocols हैं CBD के. पहला Cartagena protocol on biosafety और दूसरा है आपका Nagoya protocol. तो Cartagena protocol क्या था? So, Cartagena protocol on biosafety जो है वो 2000 यानी कि सन 2000 में adopt किया गया और ये भी एक legally binding protocol है जो कि CBD का part है और इसमें जो है ये biosafety जो measures है उससे related है यानी कि biosafety concern related to import and export of living modified organism means LMOs and commodities made from them. So, there are two major components of Cartagena protocol. First, Advanced Informed Agreement AIA and Procedure and Biosafety Clearing House. So, Advanced Informed Agreement क्या है? So, AIA under the Cartagena protocol ensure करता है कि countries जो हैं वो कहीं ना कहीं उनको information provide किया जाए ताकि जो informed decision है before agreeing the import of living and modifying organisms into their territory can be accomplished within time. And biosafety clearing house की अगर बात करें तो ये biosafety clearing house facilitate करता है the exchange of information जो कि आपका living modified organisms हैं and साथ ही साथ it assist countries in implementation of the protocol. So हम बात करते हैं rights of parties of Cartagena protocol. क्या क्या rights हैं जो कि आपकी parties या countries हैं जो Cartagena protocol के अंतर्गत आती हैं. तो every country which is a party to Cartagena protocol on biosafety as following have the following right. First, to be told in advance if they are importing something that contains LMOs or commodities made of LMOs. This is done via advance informed agreement. Second, if they don't want to accept such imports, they will inform the world community via communicating the biosafety clearing house. Third, all commodities which may contain LMO elements should be clearly labeled by experts. And fourth, that is the exporter of such commodity must inform the importing country in advance the shipment will contain LMOs. The importer must authorize such shipment. And fifth one is importing country has both opportunity and capacity to assess risk involving the products of modern biotechnology. And the sixth one is the protocol allows the countries to ban import of LMOs. Now the second was Nagoya protocol. So this protocol, also known as the biodiversity accord, saves the developing countries from foreign illegitimate bio prospecting. In earlier times, such bio prospectors would come search for natural substances, develop a drug, got it patented and sold it markets at high price. No benefit was given to the country from which that natural substances was sourced. So Nagoya protocol was adopted in 2010 and it is a legally binding protocol. It addresses the problems source countries एंड ऑफ जेनेटिक रिसोर्सेज बाई रिकॉग्नाइजिंग दियर राइट टू गेट अ शेयर इन बेनिफिट रिप्ड बाई फॉरिन बायो प्रोस्पेक्टर्स एंड नाउ राइट ऑफ पार्टीज टू नगोया प्रोटोकॉल अ सोर्स कंट्री हैज राइट टू बेनिफिट फ्रॉम एनी कमर्शियल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इट्स बायो रिसोर्सेज सच एज बेनिफिट्स मे इंक्लूड शेयर इन कैश प्रॉफिट सैम्पल of what was collected, participation or training of national researcher, transfer of biotechnology, the Nagoya Protocol reaffirms that sovereign country has full rights on its genetic resources and use of bioresources should be done only by mutual consent. It provides legal certainty, transparency, and also covers traditional knowledge. What are the obligations of parties to Nagoya Protocol? So, first is every country should create clear and unambiguous legal framework around access of its genetic resources. This framework should have clear laws, rules, procedure, etc. Every country should make clear that its consent is taken while accessing its bioresources and terms on which monetary and non-monetary benefits are to be shared. The terms should be mutually agreed and both the contracting parties must have access to justice. And other important notes on Nagoya Protocol. So, the protocol is legally binding and open only CBD ratified countries, excludes US and Andorra. The protocol is applicable only when countries' bioresources are used. Used means to conduct research and development on the genetic and or biochemical composition of genetic resources. The third covers derivative product of bioresources including drugs, antibodies, vitamins, enzymes, active compounds and metabolites. However, term derivatives is not explicitly expressed and it doesn't apply to human genetic material. And fifth, that is the last one, does not make reference to patent or any intellectual property rights. Now we shall talk about achieve target. Nagoya Protocol ends up with a strategic plan with 20 targets called Aichi targets. Objective of Aichi targets is to address the underlying causes of biodiversity loss, reduce the pressures on biodiversity, safeguard biodiversity at all levels, enhance the benefits provided by biodiversity, and provide the biocapacity building. Some Aichi targets include: first, bringing down rate of loss of natural habitats to half. Second, commitments to conserve 70% of terrestrial and inland water areas and 10% of marine areas and coastal areas through establishing protected areas. Third, restore of at least 15% degraded areas. And fourth, special efforts to reduce the pressures faced by coral reefs. And fifth, substantial increase in the level of financial resource in support of implementation of the convention. Now we would know when CBD came into India. CBD and India's Biodiversity Act. So India enacted Biodiversity Act in 2002 for giving effect to the provisions of CBD. The same is true for many developing countries also. Now the last one is the United Framework Convention on Climate Change. So United Nations Framework on Climate Change is an international environmental treaty adopted on 9th March 1992 and opened for signature at Earth Summit in Rio de Janeiro, and from 3rd June, which was extended to 14th June 1992. It then entered into force on March 21, 1994 after a sufficient number of countries had ratified it. The United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, COP25, in Madrid, Spain, on 10th December 2019, was postponed to the next year. थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो गाइस.